Hi, in this presentation we will look into the Napoleon's Cipher coursework assignment. At the end, I expect that you will be able to explain the functional requirements of the proposed coursework, to identify the main design tasks, and finally to set up a plan for the development work. I will start by the context, present an overview and the requirements of this assignment, and then identify the main tasks that you have ahead. Let's then begin by the context. I don't want to spend much time on this part, so I'll just recommend you to search for the distinction between codes and ciphers, and then check these two sources addressing the historical aspects associated to early cryptography methods. Let's now move on to the overview and requirements. You are being asked to develop an application that receives a string of ASCII codes via RS-232C and returns the same message in encrypted or decrypted form using a given key of your choice. You should consider the 26 letters in the English alphabet, and the key used in the encryption process should be hard-programmed into the FPGA, meaning that if you want to use a different encryption key, you will have to reprogram the FPGA. But how will the cipher work? Well, that is explained in this flyer from 1849 that I found in the cave of an antique bookshop in Porto. We will use a matrix with 27 lines and 27 columns, as shown in this slide. To encrypt, locate the first letter of your message in the first line. In this case, it is M. Proceed downwards, as shown in red, until you find the first letter of your key. Then proceed to the right until the last column, where you will find the letter to use in your ciphered message. Move on to the second letter and repeat the procedure, as shown in blue, and likewise until the message is completely ciphered. To decrypt, just follow the opposite path, starting again by the first letter in the received message. What tasks do you have ahead? In the case of an FSMD implementation, you should start by designing the data path architecture. You will then be able to design the ASMD chart for the control path. Make sure that you comply with the ASMD chart representation rules. You will then be ready to create the VHDL project in Vivado, including the test benches to demonstrate that your solution works as expected. In the case of a software implementation, you will have to start by building a high-level representation of the encryption and decryption algorithm, and then use Vivado and SDK to develop and simulate your C or C++ implementation. And finally, if your coursework assignment asks for an implementation in the form of an IP block, you will need to adapt and extend the work done in the previous stages in order to deliver this solution as well. Make sure that you do design verification in all cases and include in your deliverables the simulation results demonstrating that your solution works as expected. And that's all. Thanks for your attention.